7.
Present, ma'am.
8.
Present, ma'am.
9.
Present.
10.
Present, ma'am.
11.
Present, ma'am.
12.
Present, ma'am.
13.
Present, ma'am.
14.
Present, ma'am.
15.
Present, ma'am.
16.
Present, ma'am.
17.
Present, ma'am.
18.
Present.
19.
Present, ma'am.
20.
Present, ma'am.
21.
Present, ma'am.
22.
Present, ma'am.
23.
Present, ma'am.
24.
Present, ma'am.
25.
Present, ma'am.
26. 27.
Present, ma'am.
28. Absent. 29.
Present, ma'am.
30.
Present, ma'am.
31.
Present, ma'am.
32.
Present, ma'am.
33.
Present, ma'am.
34.
Present, ma'am.
35.
Present, ma'am.
36.
Present, ma'am.
37.
Present, ma'am.
38.
Present, ma'am.
39.
Present, ma'am.
40.
Present, ma'am.
41.
Yes.
41. 42.
Yes, ma'am.
43.
Yes, ma'am.
44.
Present, ma'am.
45.
Yes, ma'am.
So roll number 28 is only absent today.
Ma'am?
Yes.
कल मैं गूगल फॉर्म फिलअप करना भूल गया. अटेंडेंस का अटेंडेंस मिलेगा क्या?
नहीं, अटेंडेंस नहीं मिलेगा.
क्यों मैम? क्लास अटेंड किया मैम, लेकिन फॉर्म फिलअप करना भूल गए.
क्यों? व्हाई आर यू इररिस्पांसिबल सच? कैसे भूल सकते हो? खाना भूल गए हो क्या कल का? आज दो दिन मत खाओ और डबल डबल खा लो एक दिन, तो क्या होगा तुम्हारा उसके बाद? भूलते कैसे हो, वही तो मुझे जानना है. भूल जाते कैसे हो? क्योंकि देखो, जो डॉक्यूमेंट्स मेरे पास रहेगा, आज अटेंडेंस फिलअप करोगे गूगल फॉर्म में, तो अटेंडेंस आज का 2 times दिखाएगा उसमें. आज का डेट पे तुम्हारा 2 बार अटेंडेंस दिखाएगा. पर मेरे पास डेटा क्या होगा कि तुम्हारा अटेंडेंस, हम जब उसको अरेंज करेंगे ना गूगल फॉर्म में, जो अटेंडेंस आता है अभी, तो तुम लोगों का सीए मार्क्स तो आना देना अभी होगा, नेक्स्ट फरवरी के अंदर देना होगा कंटिन्यूअस इवैल्यूएशन के लिए. जो मार्क्स है 25 मार्क्स, तो वो जो सीए मार्क्स है उसमें जब हम तो क्या करेंगे, टोटल तो तुम्हारा डेट वाइज हम लेंगे अटेंडेंस. तो डेट वाइज अटेंडेंस में तो तुम्हारा उस डेट का अटेंडेंस नहीं रहेगा. आज का भरोगे तो आज का ही अटेंडेंस दिखाएगा ना, और एक दिन का तो 2 अटेंडेंस होगा नहीं. समझ रहे हो प्रॉब्लम क्या है?
यस मैम.
कल का अटेंडेंस तुम भर देते रात 12 बजे तक, तो अटेंडेंस कल का ही रहता. पर आज का अटेंडेंस भरोगे, आज कल का अटेंडेंस भरोगे तो आज का डेट में ही शो करेगा. तो ये ऐसा गलती मत करो. हम बोल रहे हैं मेरे पास अटेंडेंस जो है, ये जो अटेंडेंस फाइल भेजा गया है तुम लोगों के पास, एचओडी के पास हम भेजे हैं, ये है तुम लोगों का जो हम क्लास में रोल कॉल करते हैं उसके बेस पे. क्योंकि बहुत सारा अटेंडेंस पहले है कि गूगल फॉर्म में भेजना भूल गए हैं, तो इसीलिए हम गूगल फॉर्म नहीं किए हैं. अभी नहीं देख के ये जो क्लास का अटेंडेंस है वो देख के हम भेजे हैं अटेंडेंस. तुम लोगों के पास भी हम भेजे थे ग्रुप में. बट जब मार्क्स आएगा उसके तो डॉक्यूमेंट्स हमें जब रेडी करना होगा, तो तुम लोग जो अटेंडेंस भेज रहे हो वही हमें कंसिडर करना होगा. ये वाला अटेंडेंस तब नहीं होगा. तुम ये क्लास कर रहे हो नहीं कर रहे हो, मेरे पास जो डॉक्यूमेंट्स है हम रोल कर रहे हैं उसके हिसाब से. पर जब हम जो गूगल, एक्चुअली तुम लोग जो गूगल फॉर्म में जो अटेंडेंस भेज रहे हो, गूगल शीट पे मेरा मेल पे आ रहा है, गूगल शीट पे एक साथ आ रहा है, तो हम सिलेक्ट करके करके बाद में जब मार्क्स देंगे टोटल एक डेट का जितना भी अटेंडेंस आ रहा है उसको हम सिलेक्ट कर लेंगे और एक्सेल में जाके उसका परसेंटेज सब कुछ कैलकुलेट कर लेंगे उसको कॉपी पेस्ट करके गूगल शीट से। तो एक एक डेट पकड़ के हम करेंगे, मतलब तो एक के बाद एक तो सभी स्टूडेंट्स का नाम होता है एक पर्टिकुलर डेट पे, तो हम पर्टिकुलर डेट डेट करके कॉपी पेस्ट करके ये कर लेंगे। तो ये लोग तुम लोग नहीं कर रहे हो अटेंडेंस, तो तुम लोगों का जो मार्क्स है बाद वाला उसमें बहुत ही प्रॉब्लम होगा। पर हम ये जो किए हो इतना दिन तक कि गूगल में गूगल फॉर्म में अटेंडेंस नहीं भेज रहे हो तो इसका इफेक्ट तुम लोगों को बाद में मिलेगा। और ये हम रोल कॉल इसीलिए करते हैं, रोल कॉल इसीलिए करते हैं कि कोई भी स्टूडेंट क्लास नहीं कर रहा है और गूगल शीट में अटेंडेंस भेज रहे हैं तो मेरे पास तो हर दिन का अटेंडेंस कौन कौन एब्सेंट है लिखा रहता है। तो हम जब वो अटेंडेंस कॉपी करेंगे तो ये जो अटेंडेंस कोई दिया है कि एब्सेंट है उसके बाद भी अटेंडेंस दिया है गूगल शीट पे, मतलब वहां पर, तो उसका अटेंडेंस हम कंसिडर नहीं करेंगे। इसीलिए हम कॉल भी करते हैं रोल कॉल, दैट मीन्स आई एम कॉलिंग योर रोल नंबर्स एंड एज वेल एज यू आर फिलिंग अप द गूगल फॉर्म फॉर योर अटेंडेंस। So I have to check both these attendance when I will give any marks, internal marks or anything.
मैम कुछ कुछ गूगल फॉर्म में तो मैम डेट सिलेक्ट करना होता है।
कौन सा?
मैम कुछ कुछ फॉर्म में तो मैम डेट सिलेक्ट का ऑप्शन भी रहता है।
डेट सिलेक्ट हम नहीं दिए हैं, क्यों दे? क्यों दे? तुम लोगों का काम क्या है? पर्टिकुलर डेट एक क्लास करोगे उसका अटेंडेंस उस दिन नहीं भेजोगे, तुम लोगों का इतना क्या इंपॉर्टेंस आ गया है कि तुम लोग अटेंडेंस डे में नहीं भेज रहे हो? ऑप्शन दिया जाता है, हम जो अटेंडेंस फॉर्म भेजे हैं उसमें वहां पर ऑप्शन नहीं है, वहां पर एक ही ऑप्शन है, मतलब जिस डेट में फिलअप करोगे अटेंडेंस उस डेट शो करेगा। ठीक है, अभी तुम लोग फर्स्ट ईयर में हो इसलिए तुम लोगों का मुझे नहीं लगता है कि तुम्हारा अटेंडेंस का डेट सिलेक्ट करे, क्योंकि वहां पर हम ऐसा दे दे तो जो भी अटेंडेंस फिलअप कर रहा है वो भी नहीं करेगा। पिछला वाला अटेंडेंस परसों का अटेंडेंस आज करोगे, 10 दिन पहले पिछला वाला अटेंडेंस उसके बाद करोगे, और पर्टिकुलर डेट नहीं है, मतलब जिस डेट में करना है उस डेट में ही करना है, समझे?
ओके मैम।
लोगों के पास अभी कैंपसिंग भी नहीं है कि कैंपस इंटरव्यू के लिए प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हो कि कुछ भी ये कर रहे हो और इंटर्नशिप कर रहे हो, कुछ भी नहीं कर रहे हो, घर में बैठे हुए हो और उसके बाद भी अटेंडेंस नहीं दे पा रहे हो, कॉलेज आना नहीं पड़ रहा है, आना जाना आने जाने में टाइम वेस्ट नहीं हो रहा है, उसके बाद भी अटेंडेंस फिलअप नहीं हो रहा है, तो जांच करो, जांच योर सेल्फ, जांच योर सेल्फ, व्हाट आर यू डूइंग ऑल। 24 आवर्स होता है, 24 आवर्स में ये तो एक्चुअली क्लास के बाद 12 आवर्स तो तुम्हें मिल जाता है आफ्टर द क्लास, तो 12 आवर्स में भी तुम लोगों का अटेंडेंस भरना नहीं हो रहा है। देखो जो तुम लोगों का हाल कैसा है, घर में बैठ के पूरा ऐसा हाल हो गया है तुम लोगों का। सो रोल नंबर 28 इज एब्सेंट टुडे। Now in single slit diffraction, yesterday I discussed that this is the single slit, only one slit is there, and due to this single slit, what will be the intensity on the screen? That is given by this relation, total field. Actually, this is the total field. E is the total field on the screen due to the single slit. And what is this? This is A sine beta by beta sine omega t plus beta. And here this term, first term, that is A sine beta by beta. This is the, actually here this term, this is the intensity term. So here before the intensity distribution, I equal to I0 sine square beta by beta square. So I0 equal to A square and this is N square A square. So total intensity distribution that you will remember as I equal to I0 sine square beta by beta square. Remember this one. This is very important because this total formula deduction may not be given in exam. But what is given? Write down the intensity distribution. What is the formula for intensity? This is I equal to I0 sine square beta by beta square. And for principal maxima, beta, this is pi b sine theta by lambda. This is the expression of beta. This is tends to 0. As this tends to 0, so sine beta by beta, limit beta tends to 0 is 1. So from this portion, you are getting 1 and I equal to I0. So this is the maximum intensity. So the condition of principal maxima, this is beta tends to 0. And here, limit beta tends to 0, sine beta by beta, that is, this is equal to 1. And for minima, that is for this condition, this is pi and 5 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, these are the different minima. Number here, sorry, different minima is pi, 2 pi in this way. So what is the condition of minimum? Remember, beta equal to plus minus m pi, m equal to 1 to 3. Beta may be, if you put the value of m equal to 1, you will get beta plus minus pi. So at plus pi it is minima and again at minus pi it is minima. Then plus 2 pi minima and again minus 2 pi minima. So beta equal to 4 plus minus m pi, you will get minima. So this is the condition of minima. And here you know the expression of beta. This is equal to pi b sine theta by lambda. This is beta. So beta equal to plus minus m pi. And from here you can write b sine theta equal to plus minus m lambda. So this is the condition of minima. So this is the condition of maxima and this is the condition of minima. And you just remember the intensity distribution for the single slit distribution. This is very, very important. You have to remember I equal to I0 sine square beta by beta square. And E, what is this? This is the total field. Total field on the screen due to the single slit. So also you have to remember this one. E equal to A sine beta by beta sine omega t plus beta. Now, I have discussed different things. What are the conditions of maxima and minima? And graphically, it is represented. Two graphs are here, y equal to tan beta and y equal to beta. The point of intersection gives the secondary maxima. So, you can see, this is the point of intersection. So, point of intersection here. So, say this is the graph. This is the graph. This graph, it is what is this? This is y equal to tan beta. And what is this graph? This is y equal to beta. So it is cutting here. So what is the intersection on beta axis? This is beta equal to 1.43 pi. Actually, the value of the secondary maximum, this is 1.43 pi. But for easier calculation, what I am taking this value. Actually, this value. What I am taking as this value. This is what? What is this value for the secondary first secondary maximum? 3 pi by 2. See here. It is 3 pi by 2. For easier calculation, I am not taking this value beta equal to 1.43 pi. I am taking 3 pi by 2. Again, the next secondary maxima, it is beta equal to what? 2.46 pi. I am not taking this value. I am taking this value for easier calculation. This is 5 pi by 2. So, it is easier to remember. And it is difficult. You can't remember like this 1.43 pi, 2.46 pi. So, it is remember, easier remember. That you will just remember it as 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2 like this, 7 pi by 2, 9 pi by 2 like this. So for this reason, the secondary maxima are different than here. First secondary maxima, beta equal to 3 pi by 2. So here it is beta equal to 3 pi by 2, but actually it is beta equal to 1.43 pi. So this graph is very important. This graph is very important and I try to draw this graph. So deduction is not maybe your offline. If offline exam, then deduction may be given. I don't know what type of exam will be given, but actually, what is given? What is given? Discuss the intensity distribution for the intensity distribution for the single slit diffraction, and discuss the different position of maxima and minima, different conditions. So if you deduction, you can deduce also yourself. But whatever you will remember, like this, you will draw this figure. You will draw this figure. Just you will explain what is here. Then directly remember this one. This is very important. This is very important. The total expression of field due to single slit on the screen. This is this expression. Then the intensity distribution I equal to I zero sine square beta by beta square. This expression of intensity will remember. The condition of maxima. This is the condition of maxima and condition of minima. This is the condition of minima. Here beta tends to zero, and here beta equal to plus minus m pi. This is the condition of minima, and this is the figure drawing actually what is maxima and minima. Then graphically the positions are taken. The graph you will remember. This graph you will remember, and you will remember here the values beta equal to 1.43 pi. And these are the actual values of the peak position of the secondary maxima. But our easier calculation and to easier to remember, we are considering these values as 3 pi by 2. So 3 pi by 2 is first secondary maxima. Then second secondary maxima is beta equal to 5 pi by 2. Then a third secondary maxima is at what? Third secondary maxima is at what? Say anyone. Beta equal to
7 pi by 2.
7 pi by 2. Actually, this question is given. Proof that the intensity distribution for the for single slit diffraction, this is like this. So, then what you will write, if it is 3 or 4 marks, if it is your offline examination, this question is given frequently. So, you will draw this figure first. You will draw this figure here first. You will explain this is the slit and these are the refracted rays. This is the screen. Here we are getting the diffraction pattern. Then due to this slit, the field at this point on the screen, this is field position. That is the expression of field is given. And this is the expression of field. And this is the expression intensity distribution. Then you will write down these conditions. And no need to, also you have to explain here, because these two, you need beta equal to tan beta, this graph, and y equal to beta, this graph, it is needed. This portion you have to write in detail. So if you have problem in writing, then also you can start from this. The intensity distribution for single slit diffraction, we know it is like this. Start from here, I equal to I zero sine square beta by beta. Then what you will do? Then just write the principal maxima and minima position, this position. So starting from intensity, then you will write this thing. Then you will write expression, this you know, you will write di by d beta equal to this, differentiation you will do. And here you will write up to this. Then after this, you will say that graphically, we can solve this. How to find out graphically the position of secondary maxima. So this is the position of secondary maxima. Actually, see here. See here what I have given. I have given the principal maxima. The first one is for principal maxima. Second condition is what for? Second condition is for minima. So from this, starting from intensity, you have the condition of principal maxima. Then the condition of minima, that is pi to pi. But the condition of principal maxima, the condition of secondary maxima, you don't know. So these two are for principal maxima and minima. So secondary maxima, we can calculate by the graphical method. And here you will see that graphical method, this is the intensity distribution. You will calculate di by dπ, that is the differentiation. And yesterday I already discussed all these things. And here up to this, you will prove that is beta, tan beta equal to beta. Then you will come to the graph and you will show that here two graph lines are drawn here. One is y equal to beta and another graph is beta equal to tan beta. And from the intersection of the two lines, we can get the positions of the secondary maxima. and this is the actual position of the secondary maxima, but for easier calculation what we are taking it as 3 pi by 2, 5 pi by 2, 7 pi by 2, 9 pi by 2, 11 pi by 2 in this way, and in this way the secondary maxima position, that is for first, second, third, fourth, in this way we will calculate. So you know already I1 equal to I0 sin squared beta by beta squared, put it here, beta equal to 3 pi by 2, 3 pi by 2, you will get this. And in this way, this is the ratio given, and dot sign represents that it is third secondary maxima, fourth secondary maxima. And you can see the intensity here, it is decreasing gradually. In the intensity here, for this is the first secondary maxima, here intensity is maximum. For second secondary maxima, intensity is less than this. For third secondary maxima, intensity is less than the second one. In this way, the intensity is decreasing. And the ratio is given like this. 1 is to 1 by 22 is to 1 by 61 is to 1 by 121. In this way, the ratio of intensity is decreasing. So, this question is very important. That is, it is given the intensity is decreasing for intensity is decreasing for secondary maxima in this order. So, this question, for long answer type question, it may be given that prove that the intensity distribution for the simultaneously diffraction is like this, that is I equal to I0 sin square beta by beta square, but it may be given the probability is less, but what may be given from this portion, that write down the intensity distribution for the single slit diffraction, you will write I equal to I0 equal sin square beta by beta square, then you will explain the condition of principal maxima, then minima, and the conditions of secondary maxima, first order, second order, third order, like this, and this graph and this portion is very important. So that was the discussion of yesterday. Why I discussed it today? Because today now I'm going to discuss double slit diffraction. So same thing I will discuss there, but here there are two slits. In space of one slit, you will get two slit. Okay, so this is the double slit diffraction. So same. So is it visible, this page? Is this page visible?
Yes, ma'am.
So you can see two slits are there. What is the first slit? AB. Understand? And what is the second slit? This is CD. So two slits are there. Now, this for one slit, what will happen at this screen? On the screen P, you know. And in the same way, for this slit, you will get the effect. Now, here is the, what is here? This is the interference. Interference between the two slits here. And you are getting the pattern. So what is here? Let us say plane wavefront of monochromatic light of wavelength lambda. Same thing is here. So yeah, before this, another lens is convex lens is there to get this light. Now this is coming here. Let a plane wavefront of monochromatic light of wavelength lambda be incident normally on the two slits AB and CD. So AB and CD are the two slits of width B, and this is the. That it has width B, and B you can see that AB and CD, this is B, and this space, this is BC, BC equal to A, this space, this is not the slit, actually slit width is AB and CD, but here it is not the slit. So in this position, so from this position BC, the light can't travel, okay, only light passes through AB and CD, because this is the slit width. Now, two slits AB and CD of width B placed perpendicular to the plane of the paper, we have to calculate the intensity distribution due to the diffraction on the screen XY placed at the focal point of the length L. So same position here, this screen is placed on the focal position of this length, of this lens. Now we have to calculate the intensity distribution due to diffraction on the screen XY placed at the focal point, okay. We assume that each point on the slit is a source of secondary wavelength. This was the same assumption for the single slit. We know, so different points you can see here, A1, A2, A3 up to AN. And here for this slit, B1, B2, B3, B4 up to BN. So these are different points here. in the slip B and A, B and C D. So each point on the screen, first on the slate here, each point A1, A2, A3, they are acting as each point. That is, this is the source of secondary wavelets. So this is again same assumption. Interference takes place between the wavelets originating from two such secondary sources. So interference takes place, and these slits consist of a large number of secondary point sources which are equispaced. And you know these points are equispaced. That is A1, A2, this is same distance. A2, A3, this is at same distance. So they are equispaced. So let A1, A2, A3, A4 in this way, B1, B2, B3, B4 be the point sources on the both the slits. If the diffracted rays make an angle theta normal to the plane, you can see this is the diffraction angle, it is shown here. So now what we will consider, initially we were considering only one slit and only these points. Now here, what we are considering? We are considering this angle. Here it is d sin theta. What is this? This is B1. So between this point and this point, it is d sin theta. See here, if the diffracted rays makes an angle theta normal to the plane of the slit, then the path difference between the waves reaching the point P on the screen from the consecutive point in the slit, that is delta sin theta. Can you see the zoom mode?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now this clear figure is clear for you. So this is this angle, theta angle. The ray, if it is goes in this direction, the ray, it is that is not diffracted. So it is going in this direction. This is bending of light. So this is the angle theta. Now what I am considering? The first point here. The first point here and here, this is the difference, path difference. So what is the path difference? It is B1, B2 dash. B1, B2 dash. If you consider this ray, if you consider this ray, the first point of this slit and the first point of this slit, the light from this point, it is going diffracted in this direction, and the light from this point, that is going in this direction. So what are the path difference between the two rays? This is B1, B2 dash. This is the path difference. And what is D? D equal to A plus B. See here, what is D? D, it is path difference is D sin theta. And what is D? D equal to A plus B. So D equal to C from what is A? A is BC and B is AB. So here D equal to A plus B. That is our assumption here. That is D equal to A plus B. So this distance B plus this distance A. So this is our D. So the path difference between the two rays from coming from A1 and B1, what is the path difference? Because this path, if I put any point here, if I put here, say, C point is here, or we can't say here, if I put here M point here, if I put here M point, then B2 dash M. And if it is N here, then A1 N, they are same. B2 dash M and A1 N, if I put here N point, then A1 N and B2 dash M, they are same. But this is the difference between the path, between the two rays, because the light, this is the point of secondary source, secondary wavelets is originating from this source. Now, the light coming from A1 and the light coming from B1, these two lights has path difference. What is the path difference between the two lights? Say, B2, B2 dash. B2, B2 dash is the path difference between the two lights originating from A1 and B1. Okay. So what is the path difference? B1 and B2 dash? What is this? Say anyone.
D sin theta. D sin theta.
This is the path difference. So this is the path difference. Okay. actually what I was considering initially it was delta, so here it is D actually. Here it is D because when I was discussing about the single slit, then the distance between the two points, what was that? A1 and A2, it was delta. Is it? If I consider only single slit, then A1 and A2, this distance is delta, A2, A3, this distance is delta. But here, this delta, this becomes D here because I am just considering now two slits consecutively. So this distance is now D. So it is D sine theta. Remember this one. Now the field produces by the slit AB. Now this calculation already we have done. Now E1. So field is producing at P due to this slit, and also field is producing at P due to this slit, second one. So the field producing due to the first slit at P, this is the expression we have already proved. E1 equal to A sine beta by beta sine of omega t plus beta. Already I have proved this one. And single slit diffraction. So since N minus 1, actually it was N minus 1 into phi by 2. And phi equal to 2 pi by lambda into delta sine theta. Delta sine theta I am considering here for the first slit. So the delta is between the distance between A1 and A2. So this is delta. So as I have discussing, I am discussing the only the first one. Is slit, so I am taking it delta. But when we will consider two slits consecutively, then we have to take it is D. Now this is the formula N minus 1 phi by 2. Now N minus 1 phi by 2, we can write it that N phi by 2 because N is very large. So N is very large means number of points you can know, you can see that is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6 in this way in AN. So N number of points say there are in slit A, in AB slit. So as N is very large, so we can neglect this one. So it is N minus 1 into phi by 2. As N is very large, so we can neglect this one. So we can write this as N phi by 2. So here, what we can write? We can write it as N phi by 2, and that is equal to beta. Now E1, that is the field produced by the slit AB at P. So field produced by the slit AB at P. So this I have already discussed. Now I am coming to the previous one for single slit. This thing that I have already discussed, and I told you that to remember this one. So this is the formula. E equal to this into this. So ultimately, this is the expression. E equal to what? A sine beta by beta sine of omega t plus beta. And this is the term, N minus 1, phi by 2. N minus 1, phi by 2. So, this expression for single slit diffraction, you already know. Now, I am coming from double slit diffraction. So, for when I am considering double slit diffraction, we have to take for individual slit. So, for slit 1, this is the expression of field here at this point P. Now again E2. E2 is what? E2. E2 is the field. What is E2? E2 is the field due to this slit. E2 is the field. E2 is the field due to this CD slit on P. So separately we are considering what is the field due to first slit on P and what is the field due to second slit on P. So similarly we can write E2 equal to A sine beta by beta sine of omega t plus beta minus phi 1. Actually, what is here? Say, E1 equal to A sine beta by beta sine of omega t plus beta. This is the field due to the first slit on P. Now, this is the field due to the second slit on P. This is the expression of field. And what is the beta plus omega t it was initially? See, it is beta plus omega t. Now, there is some phase difference between the this here expression of the two fields. So this phase difference between the field, first field and the second field, this is the phi 1. So phi 1. And what is this phi 1? Phase difference equal to what? 2 pi by lambda into path difference. So phase difference equal to 2 pi by lambda into path difference. And what is the path difference between these two? What is the path difference? D sine theta. Between the two, it is path difference is D sine theta. So I am writing here that 2 pi by lambda into d sine theta. That is the path difference. So this is the phase difference. So phase difference between E1 and E2, that is phi 1. So phi 1 is the phase difference between E1 and E2. So phi 1 represents the phase difference between the two waves of two corresponding points on the double slit. D is the distance between the corresponding points at double slit. So D is the distance of the distance between the two corresponding points. So this is the distance, and you can write this distance as d sine theta. So between the two corresponding points, it is d. So distance between A1, B1, this is d. See here. What is the distance between A1, B1? What is this distance? This is? Say?
D sine theta.
No. A1, this A. point and this point.
A plus B.
No. See here. This actually, this is D. This is D. Okay. If I consider this point A2 and B2, what is this distance? This is again D. Okay. This is again D. If I consider A3 and B3, what is this distance? D. So D is the distance between the two consecutive points. Now it is D sine theta. Now if I get again take one perpendicular from A2 to B2 here, then again these two, this ray and this ray, it has phase difference what? Again d sine theta. So this is the distance A1 B1 equal to A2 B2 equal to A3 B3 equal to A4 B4 in this way. And what is the distance? This is d is the distance. And what is the path difference? Path difference is d sine theta. So now what we are getting, we have the field due to first slit on P, and also we have the field due to second slit on P. Now we have to the total field. What will be the total field on P? That is E1 plus E2. So already it is given E1 expression and E2. So just add this to E equal to E1 plus E2. The A is the common portion, put it outside. Sin beta by beta sin omega t plus beta plus sin beta by beta sin omega t plus beta minus phi by 2. So now mathematically just write. So this is the common term, put it outside, sin beta by beta. So what remains? Sin of omega t plus beta plus sin of omega t plus beta minus phi by 2. So mathematically you can add, you know this formula. Now, so we can write this as this expression. So 2a sin beta by beta. So sin beta by beta always here. First term and second term in both the terms. So put it outside. So you will get 2 cos of phi by 2 and sin of omega t plus beta minus phi by 2. You will get this term. So mathematically you can write this. Now what I am writing? That 2a sin beta by beta, then cos gamma sin of omega t plus beta minus phi by 2. So what is cos gamma here? Gamma is what? Gamma equal to phi by 2. So phi by 2 is here. So phi by 2 I am just considering as gamma. And what is this? And phi 1 is already there. Pi d sin theta by lambda. Phi 1. This is the value of phi 1. You can see phi 1 equal to pi d. Actually phi 1 equal to what? 2 pi by lambda d sin theta. So it is phi 1 by 2. So divided by 2, so you will get this one. So what is the value of gamma? Gamma equal to pi d sin theta by lambda. So this expression, 2a sin beta by beta square cos gamma sin of omega t plus beta minus phi by 2. So this is the expression of the field. Now what is the intensity? The first term you have to consider. What is the intensity of the intensity distribution of the double slit? You can see, square it. 4a square sin square beta by beta square cos of square gamma. So leave this sine term, this term. Then leaving this, the intensity we can write I equal to what? Here the term, it is 2a sin beta by beta cos gamma. This is the intensity term. So square this term. So 4a square sin square beta by beta square cos of square gamma. So this is the intensity distribution due to the double slit at P. So this is the intensity distribution. Okay. So this is the intensity distribution. Now we can write this intensity. You have to remember this one. I equal to, if it may be given, write down the intensity distribution for the double slit diffraction. So intensity distribution for the double slit diffraction is I equal to 4a square sin square beta by beta square cos square gamma. So I'm just writing it as I1 and I2. I1 is what? I1 equal to 4a square sin square beta by beta square, and I2 equal to what? Cos square gamma. So it is, we can write it as I1 into I2. Now this is the term. Intensity I equal to I1 into I2. What is I1 here? I said, what is I1?
4 a square times beta square.
And what is I2? Cos square gamma. Okay. So see here. So two different terms are plotted like this. So this is the direction of beta along x-axis. And here it is plotted. What is the term for? This is the term I2 is plotted. Cos square gamma versus beta. And here it is this is I2 versus beta. This is the graph. This is I1 versus beta. And this is the sum of intensity. So this is the total. If we take the total, if we superpose these two terms, then we will get the term. This is the term. So this is the term as a whole. This is I. So here it is I. I equal to what? 4I0. This term. So this is the term. So you can see. So minima, that is third one. That is this point is third order is minima. It is 6 is minima. Here 3 is minima, 6 is minima. So this is the resultant intensity. This is the resultant intensity distribution graphically. And these are the two terms are shown. I1 and I2. So remember this term. This is a very important term. What is this term? The intensity distribution due to a double slit diffraction. This is I equal to 4 square sine square beta by beta square cos square gamma. Here I1 represents the diffraction pattern due to single slit. So I1 is what? I1 is the diffraction pattern due to the single slit, and I2 represents the interference pattern produces by the two point sources separated by distance d. So two terms are there. One is diffraction pattern and another is interference pattern. So I1 and what is I1 and I2, it is represented here. So you will try to draw this figure. Now this intensity distribution is very important. So only the here what I have done. So already we know that what will be the field due to the first slit, what will be the field due to the second slit, that we know. Now we will take the sum of these two fields. The field E1 we know, field E2 we know. Now we will take the sum of these two fields and we will calculate the total intensity distribution here. So this is the form of the total intensity distribution. I equal to 4 square sine square beta by beta square cos square gamma. Now it is shown here graphically. Now missing order. This is very important. Now from this figure you can see it is clear that one interference maxima coincides with the minima. See here. What is this term? Interference term. What is this term? I2? I2 is the interference term and this is the diffraction. This is the diffraction. Diffraction pattern and this is the interference pattern. And the total intensity is the sum of I1 and I2. See, if one interference maxima coincides with the minima of the diffraction, then that maxima of the interference pattern will be absent from the resultant pattern, and this is called the missing order. So I'm just expressing later from this graph. First, that is that we know this formula, minima, the diffraction minima. Do you know this formula? B sin theta equal to plus minus m lambda. Do you know this condition of diffraction minima? I have proved this. I'm coming there. Diffraction, this is diffraction due to single slit. So diffraction minima, what is the condition of diffraction minima? See, B sin theta equal to plus minus m lambda. So B sin theta equal to plus minus m lambda. So this is the condition of diffraction minima. Here. So B sin theta equal to plus minus m lambda, that I have proved. This is the condition of diffraction minima. Now, but the position of interference maxima will change because the condition of interference maxima. Now, interference maxima, this is d sin theta. Remember this one. D sin theta equal to a plus b sin theta. That is equal to plus minus m dash lambda. So, this is the interference maxima. This is the condition of interference maxima. So, condition of diffraction minima is this. this is the condition of interference maximum. So as interference is not in your syllabus, only diffraction is there, and not possible for me to complete optics in 5 lectures. So you can think, so I'm not discussing all these things. I can't discuss because I can't end my syllabus. So you will remember this one only, that the condition for interference maxima, this is d sin theta equal to a plus b sin theta. So I can write it like this. Now both are, now if I divide this, so a plus b sin theta, so a plus b sin theta divided by b sin theta. A plus B sin theta divided by B sin theta. So sin theta cancels, and you will get A plus B by B. Then what is here? M dash by M. So you have these two expressions. Just divide A plus B sin theta by B sin theta equal to what? Plus equal to what? Plus minus M dash lambda divided by plus minus M lambda. So in the right hand side, you will get like this. That is M dash by M. So this is the condition. A plus B by B equal to M dash by M. Now if A equal to 2B, just put A equal to 2B. So what you will get? 2B plus B, that is 3B by B. So you are getting here 3B by B, that is 3 is to 1. So M dash equal to 3M. M dash equal to 3M, you have this expression. So put now here M equal to 1, 2, 3. So if you put M equal to 1, then M dash equal to what? If you put M equal to 1, then M dash equal to what?
3.
If you put M equal to 2, M dash equal to what? 6. If M equal to 3, M dash equal to what? 9. Thus, the 3, 6, 9 interference maxima will be absent from the resultant pattern. So, these are the missing orders. So, missing orders depends on this A and B, these two parameters. So if A equal to 2B, if A equal to 2B in this condition, 3, 6, 9 interference maxima will be absent from the resultant pattern. Say here, A equal to 2B. See here, 3, this 3 position is crossed. So this is not existing. 3 is crossed. Again, 6 is crossed. Okay, so here again the same thing is here written, A equal to 2B. This is shown here for A equal to 2B. So 3 is absent, 6 is absent, and then again 9 is absent. And in this way, these orders will be absent from the, so these are called the missing orders. Now, what is clear that if the interference maxima coincides with the minima of the diffraction pattern. Now come here. Now, I have to again another thing, that if A equal to B, then what is the condition? A equal to B put here. This is given. This missing order is very, very important. I'm saying again and again, this missing order is very, very important. It is shown here. Calculate the missing order for A equal to B. So if A, remember this formula, A plus B by B equal to M dash by M. This formula, very important for missing order. Now, if A equal to B, then M dash equal to 2M. Then what are the missing orders? Then it is 2, 4, 6. Interference maxima will be absent from the resultant pattern. So these are the interference maxima. So interference maxima 2 is absent. You can see 4 is absent. So cross sign is here. So this interference maxima is absent. So 2 absent, 4 absent, 6 absent. In this way, 8 will be absent. So these are the missing orders for A equal to B. And if A equal to 2B, then what are the missing orders? Say A equal to 2B, what are the missing orders of the interference maxima?
So
3, 6, 9, these are the missing orders. Now come here. For A equal to B, I am saying here, it is A equal to B. So what is here? It is that interference maxima coinciding with the minima of the diffraction. See here. What is this? Maxima? What is this? This point? Maxima or minima?
Maxima.
Maxima. What is this point? Minima? This is the interference pattern. This is the interference pattern. So, the maxima of the interference pattern, can you see this point? The maxima of interference pattern is coinciding with which? Minima of, this is minima, is it? What is this? Minima of, this is diffraction pattern, this is interference pattern, and this is the sum, total. So, the maxima, see here, the maxima of interference pattern, it is coinciding with which? the minima of diffraction pattern, is it? So this position and this position, these are same. See, this is on the same line. So the maximum of diffraction pattern, it is coinciding with minima of which?
Diffraction pattern.
Diffraction pattern. Now, see here the resultant pattern. This is the resultant pattern. This is missing. What is missing here? 3. Okay. Again, come to 6. This line. See here. This is minimum of diffraction pattern. And this is the maxima of interference pattern. They are coinciding in this point. So, maxima of interference pattern and the minima of diffraction pattern, it is coinciding. Now, here again, we are getting the missing order. Okay? Understand? So,
yes,
when we are getting the missing orders, when the maxima of the interference pattern, it is coinciding with the minima of the diffraction pattern, in these points, we are getting missing orders. Now, this system is calculated for A equal to 2B. Okay. So, different conditions may be given, they are given there. So, in this way, the order, which will be the missing order, this will depend on A and B. So, but condition missing order is that is the maximum of interference pattern. This is coinciding with the minimum of diffraction pattern. Where it will coincide, then in that each point, you will get the missing orders. And you can see for A equal to 2B, the missing orders are at 3, 6, 9 like this. And here, it is for A equal to B. You can see the missing orders are 2, 4, 6, then 8. In this way, you will get. Understand? So, this is the concept of missing order. So, for this, so different problems are given here for double slit diffraction. You will read this. I am sending this PDF, PPT PDF. Now, for double slit diffraction, what is very important for you, what you have to remember, in double slit diffraction, the intensity distribution of the double slit diffraction, this is the term that you have to remember, 4a square sine square beta by beta square cos square gamma. So, if it is given about double slit diffraction, so you will write, you will draw this figure and you will write the field due to this slit on this P, it is E1. The field due to this slit on this P, on this point P is E2. We have to take the sum of these two. So, you will write like this. You have to take the sum of these two. If I take the sum, you will get this term. And this is the intensity intensity term. And I equal to 4A square sine square beta by beta square cos square gamma. This is equal to I1 into I2. I1 is the term due to the diffraction. And I2 is the term due to the interference. So, two terms are here. Now, interference term and the diffraction term, it is shown here graphically. Now, missing orders, you will explain where the interference maxima is coinciding with the diffraction minima. There we are getting the missing orders. Now, this is the two conditions. We are equating these two conditions and from there, we are getting A plus B by B equal to this. So, this formula you will remember. You will get mathematical problems from here. So, remember this formula. This portion is very important. Okay. So, this portion is very important. Now, from here, we can calculate the missing orders and it depends on A and B. And for A equal to 2B, the missing orders are shown here, elaborately here. So, elaborately, it can be shown. It is 3, 6, 9. Again, if you draw, extend this figure. If you extend this figure in this direction, also in left and right, you will get again the missing orders at 9. At here, at is, after 6, it will be at 9. So, this is very important. So, remember, missing orders are very important in double slit diffraction. Intensity distribution of double slit diffraction is very important. This graph is very important. And that expression of intensity, you will remember I1, I2, you will remember. You will remember E1 and E2. So, if you can't understand that single slit diffraction, it is problematic for you to remember double slit diffraction. So, actually, the time is over and you have class. So, I'm ending my class. I will send it to your group, this my note. Okay. Now ending my lecture because the time is over. Where I am?
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.